Recently, I learned that the painting Elegy to the Spanish Republic by Robert Motherwell was one of a series of paintings by that name. I always love it when artists paint in series. I will show you what I learned from painting like Robert Motherwell, so you can do it too, just after this. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art, yourself and the world around you. Robert Motherwell was an American painter who lived from 1950 until 1991. Known as one of the abstract expressionist painters of the New York School and for his paintings like these. I will start with these from the Robert Motherwell Open series. I read somewhere he couldn't get two frames apart in his studio, and when he did succeed, the shape of the smaller one was still visible on the other one. It was enough to trigger his Open series of over 100 paintings. I just love stories like that, simple and also very relatable. I love it when artists are open about where they find their inspiration. Let's see how this smaller piece looks on a bigger sheet and when it becomes an interesting composition. Motherwell always moved the shape to the edge of the paper. Or try other color combinations. At first I had trouble with the name Open, when looking at the square positioned at the edge of the paper. The edge of the paper seems in a way to close it off again. Then I saw a picture like this. A door is always at the border of a house, the bottom one. When playing like this, a so-called door can be placed on any edge of the paper. For my own version, I take cadmium red and lemon yellow acrylics and mix them with acrylic medium gloss. Because I don't want it to be too sterile, I mix more orange on the way. Because I work with transparent paint, I apply a second layer to make it less wild. Do remember to lift your sheet of the tablecloth every now and then, otherwise you won't get them apart later on. I check for a second, take a charcoal stick and draw my open shape. When making your version, you can adjust the length or the width of the lines. I use some more paint and react on a new shape by creating darker and lighter areas. As you can see, it's not that difficult as an exercise. What I like is the simple idea behind the series. When you accept the challenge, just start playing around and follow your intuition. Make other versions and see where you end up, just as Motherwell did. I crumble some charcoal and paint over it. These last two were recently auctioned. This is a little kitchen unit in my studio, and the cropped image of only the doors just looks perfect for the Open series. Again, I paint the whole sheet. This time I take white, mixed with a little bit of burnt sienna, to get to this off-white color. First I paint the opening between the doors, and now other lines to create, in my opinion, an interesting image. Whatever you use as inspiration when painting, feel free to step away from it and start to follow your own ideas. Thank you. Oh, and the two little paint stains I will explain later on in this video. I add some extra color here and there, make it not too perfect, just as the previous painting. The next series of paintings we will look at is the Elegy to the Spanish Republic. I had to look it up. A poem of mourning is called an elegy. Motherwell made this painting for a poem made by a friend about the Spanish Civil War from 1936 till 1939, costing between 200 and 500,000 lives. First, an explanation. The paintings all have round shapes and rectangular ones. There are several explanations and interpretations for these shapes, but let's see what will happen. When I place the balloons between the bricks and I push it to squeeze them, they are stuck. When I take one brick away, you get a totally different situation. Now it looks like the balloons keep the bricks trapped. When you use these bigger and heavier bricks like this, the balloons are free to go. Now one gets stuck. Now the other one too. And some extra pressure. When painting, it's all about relative size and relative distance to create tension. As I add more paint, the situation and image changes and, in my opinion, the energy too. At this point, I'm looking for things to add to the composition. Motherwell himself stated about a series of paintings, the pictures are general metaphors of the contrast between life and death and their interrelation. Some see the round shapes as people and the rectangular ones as coffins, relating to the number of victims. Over the years, he came back to this theme and made between 150 and 200 paintings and sketches. Making art is about doing the work. Usually you only see the finished painting. By making a series of paintings, Motherwell reveals how he creates art. By painting in his style, I learn a bit how he works, and I also get that I still have lots to learn. I arrive at this. I also made this one. I don't know. This one, made with a big palette knife or painting knife, looks more interesting. For this one I use it again. I love to work quick and dirty, so I don't have much time to think and trust my intuition to take over. I noticed I find it very interesting to make abstract paintings like these. Every time I have to think about the composition, what I want to tell this time, and from what perspective. Intriguing. The series is totally different from the open series we saw before, just as the next one we will look at, the Besides the Sea series. Motherwell had a studio at the beach in Provincetown, Massachusetts. The terrace had a massive concrete seawall, and at a high tide with a strong southwest wind, he enjoyed the sea spray spurting up, sometimes taller than a man, above the seawall. I grew up close to the beach and I love it too. Looking for ways to make one myself, I first tried paint and a 10mm brush. The paint turns out to be too thick, so I mixed with acrylic medium gloss and things work better. I add some extra diluted acrylic medium and this works great. The next thing is to control my swing and to get the swoosh in the direction I want. Trying out different ways. A 40mm brush or a different color. I can continue for this like hours, but actually I paint only 1 second at a time. I also try a 5mm brush for a few times and from multiple angles. This last one is made with a 10mm brush using two colors at the same time. When you look at these Modderwell beside the sea paintings, in total he made 64 of them, you will discover he used the same colors for the sea spray as for the thick lines beneath it. So I quickly rescue my thrown away palette from the trash can. I now also can reveal where the paint stains on my kitchen unit came from. When my paintings were drying, they lay over 1.5 meters away from my table, apparently still too close for me painting the sea spray. I paint my lines trying out different shaped palette knives and a brush. Again, I'm looking for the right way and it's nice to have a number of these splashes to work with. I especially love this one. I even framed it. Painting in a series has this extra that you can try out what works best. If you're interested in working with different materials, I can introduce you to an Italian artist who took painting in a direction no one ever expected. Click on the link and I will see you over there in the next video.